Hi, welcome to the spring semester 2017, and Happy New Year. I'd like to kind of talk through the course overview with you and start off with this class is really it's about you and your next immediate career step. And what I mean by this is a couple of things that all organizations are interested in is can a person lead? Can they manage? Can they work well with others? And how well can they accept responsibility as they move up in the organization? Well, this course prepares you for all of that exactly. And not only that, in addition, there are behavioral interview questions with each module to prepare you for that actual interview that helps you get your dream job. And I know one of the things past students have reported is that this class, more than any other, was particularly helpful to them in preparing them for that dream job interview or for moving up within the organization. You're watching right down here, as you can see, you're watching this video now, and notice that it considers these questions. Are you looking to step into leadership? Are you driven to make a difference in the world? Do you consider yourself a motivated achiever? And are you looking to break out of your shell and set your sights higher? And if you said answer to any of these, then this class is for you. Now let's take a look at the menu over here on the left. Announcements are important. You need to check this each time you log in. That's primarily how I will interact and communicate with the class. There'll be announcements each week, including when I get to the syllabus, including my availability. It'll come through announcements. So you want to, same way, sometimes there'll be reminders on assignments. So you want to check that. I will talk you through the syllabus, and I will show you modules. The modules are where the content and the text are located. And the good news here is you don't have to purchase a text. It's built in. It's free. It's part of the course, and I'll show you how. And then under people, this is where you will find groups have been organized, and you've been randomly assigned to a group, and that's where you will do your discussion posts. And then of course, there's grades that help you to keep track with that. So now let's take a look at syllabus. All right, here we are in Management 3600, Organization Theory and Behavior, and it is a 16-week design. My name is Rick Fenwick. My cell phone is 248-792-1222. It's best to schedule an appointment for a phone call. You sometimes can randomly get a hold of me. I tend not to answer numbers I don't recognize, so if you try it, leave a voicemail, and I'll get back to you when I can. But I say it's best to schedule an appointment. For office hours, what you'll see, also, by the way, do not send emails directly because they tend to get lost and or could. I receive emails from multiple sources. The best way is to use the inbox provision on Canvas because that tracks and keeps it organized for me. For office hours, what I've planned to do is I have a conference call number that I will post for times that I will have that number open. So when you phone in, I'll be on the line. And not only that, it will hold multiple callers. So it'll be an open discussion for whoever calls in during that period of time. And I say so. And if you need a private discussion, then schedule an appointment. But my intent is to schedule office hours as frequent as needed by the class. So we'll kind of work through that together as we go. And as you can see here, description of the course, it addresses organization theory and behavior. The main topics, and these are fundamental topics: motivation, decision making, leadership, group dynamics, and organization structure. So I think you'll find that these are very relevant. If we look over here in the assignments and how they're weighted, Discussion boards are really important. There's more than one question and a format to follow. They notice they're 40%, so you really want to spend some quality time completing these. Your group discussions do count. There are module quizzes, and they collectively together equal 30%. You'll have two chances to complete them, and it'll keep your higher score. There's a midterm and a final exam. They're not cumulative. The midterm will cover content from week one to the midterm, and the final will cover content from after the midterm to the final. There are practice quizzes with the modules. You can take them three times. They draw from the same question bank, so they're really good at preparing you. So I encourage you to take advantage of that. Extra credit, there may not be extra credit. Just depends. This course is a collaborative effort. I'm working with Dr. Katie on this course. We're adding a third professor in the summer. And so sometimes, and also you'll see there's been some students who have contributed and collaborated. So if we decide that we're going to take feedback and we need your input, then we'll provide extra credit for that. And if we do, it's not graded by points, but it's just considered you made a quality contribution at the end of the course. If you have a close grade, 1 or 2 points, it'll bump you up. But as of right now, I don't have anything scheduled. Now, this is a video by Daniel Pink. I don't know if you're familiar with at RSA Animate, but they do a terrific job of graphically illustrating lectures. And they did this with Daniel Pink's lecture on motivation, and it's a very good lecture. It's entertaining. He also presents some points that are a bit counterintuitive in that there's limits to reinforcement and incentives, and he talks about what's more powerful than that. So you need to watch this video. There'll be some questions on the quiz related that come out of that. The details I will be going through with you here in a minute, and we'll talk about doing that. And then and once again, the schedule is a 16-week schedule, so you can click and check that out. Also, you notifications, encourage you to set that up. It seems to be helpful in organizing. And let's go through assignments description here. Notice that the mini practice quizzes, once again, there's three takes. Then there's module quizzes with two takes. You have 75 minutes to complete 50 questions, so you need to be well prepared. And then we have the discussion board forms you'll post within your group. And then there's the midterm and the final, and those are scheduled separately. So you can see right here assignment summary by due dates. Notice that the group discussion and quiz for the Start Here module are completed during week one. That's the only way, the only one like that. Once we hit week two and we get in, and what this is here, this is, I will periodically post some updates on how we're doing performance. But once we hit week two, we kind of start a rhythm where you have a week to read the content, do your discussion posts, your primary posts, in other words, answering the questions, your practice quizzes, and you complete the module quiz. And then for the second week, you participate in the group discussions. And so this seems to be a pretty good flow, and you can see this takes place each week. And the midterm is scheduled by itself. We'll cover the first four modules, and then Same way, the final is posted by itself, and it covers the last three modules here. Okay, let me see. I think what I want to do next is go through the details with you. So let's go back up. Notice here that one of the things I've learned, maybe you have as well, that sometimes you click on something directly, it's difficult to get back to this page where you started. So what I like to do is right click, and for me, I like opening in a new tab. And so mine's, it's in the process of opening right there. There you go. And once again, here we see course details. And this is kind of a repeat. This course is for you. Once again, it's, like I say, it was designed to prepare you for that dream job. And focusing on the content that makes a difference, that matters. And this has been the feedback that we've got, once again, especially with the behavioral interview questions. Students have really found them helpful. This is a video, it's a testimonial by a student about how it was helpful. So you may want to check that out. Table of contents, let's run through this. Once again, it kind of gives an overview of how the modules are organized. I kind of explained week one's different, but once we hit week two, you're kind of in this rhythm or this flow. And I think you'll find that that works well. Things tend to be due on Monday, so the week will start on Tuesday and run through Monday. This gives you the weekend. A lot of people need that weekend time to complete assignments, so we've built that into the flow, and that seems to work really well. Okay, next, how much will we cover? Well, you notice here, this is the typical example where people get are really overwhelmed with how much is covered. And you can see right here, for example, 15 to 20 chapters is typical. You can see one is as high as 26 chapters there. And so what we've done through an analysis of the major texts, we've been able to boil things down to what are the really the fundamental content chapters that make a difference, that matters. And by doing that, we're able to spend more time, more quality time, preparing you in such a way that it sticks with you after the course, and you're more prepared to meet your own personal goals. A textbook, once again, the textbook is free. It's built in to the modules. You'll see that. I'll show you here as we move on. It's a streamlined modular approach, and that allows us, let's say once again, to spend some quality time with these top seven chapters. Notice that we use the first three letters as an acronym for each of the chapters. The reason for that is because they show up on devices as well as other features of Canvas, with the three letters much better. So STA is for start here, and FUN is for fundamentals, GRO groups, HUM, human resources, so you can see, so on. So when you see these acronyms, you'll know what they're talking about. There's no book costs, so, and as I know you know, these book costs can really be expensive. So we've saved you that, and I think you'll be pleased with the content that we're providing. It is a collaboration, so we'll have to decide if before the course ends that we can build in a chance for you to collaborate with us as well. Let's look. Whoops, I got ahead here. Down here at the bottom, this is a little bit hard. You can see part of it, but the chapter structure. Each chapter has an introduction. Then it has a competency A, a competency B, and a competency C. And with each competency, you'll see there's course content. Then there's a challenge, and then you solve the challenge. And then it ends with a conclusion or debrief of the chapter. And they all follow that structure. Now, the actual challenge is based upon a case simulation. It's called innovators.com, or IDC for short. And you'll see it's a case study. You'll read a dialogue. And in many cases, you'll see there's a transcript, or you can see a video that was acted out in a student contribution, which are pretty good. A lot of people like the videos. And so you get your mission by reading and watching episode one. And then it also provides content, competency one does. So you'll use the content from the competency to solve the challenge in challenge A. And then same thing, you'll do that to solve challenge B and then challenge C. And then in episode two, you'll see the results of the challenge. So that is the format. And once again, I say there's transcripts and videos, your choice. This is an example of how they're organized again. And a key is to use the content provided in the competency in solving the challenge. You'll want to demonstrate that in your primary post to your group. And that's a key to getting a good grade in that assignment, is following the format and using the content provided in the competency to get through the challenge. And so the modules are all designed that way. If we look at the flow, the Canvas calendar and modules are the official guides for due dates, so you can always check those. Once again, notifications are helpful. The modules are spread pretty equal. I say week one moves the fastest, but it also has the least content. And then we hit the two-week format. All the due times are 11 p.m. unless specified differently. And as you can see, if you look at that two-week flow, there's windows of opportunity to complete the work. And based on feedback in the past, these windows provide an adequate amount of time. And so you're expected to be able to complete that within that that amount of time. Once again, just a different way to organize it and think about it. Step one, so this would be, say, the first major content module that starts in week two. You would read all of the content, take your practice quizzes that are not graded, and then you answer the multiple questions for the module post. So you want to make sure you review the instructions, address the questions, follow the example that provides a format counts, use the grade rubric to make sure you've met all expectations, and then complete the module quiz. And you'll do that by Monday, and which if the class here starts today on January 9th, then that's all this would be due on the 16th. And then now when I say the 16th, then week one is a little bit different. So be week two, you go to the following Monday to complete step one. And then for step two, this would be the second week of the content modules. Then you participate in the group discussion, because everyone in the group now is posted. We're in groups. Why are we in groups? Because that really reduces the reading and increases the quality of your interaction. You certainly wouldn't want to be in a position to have to read the post for the entire class. You want to generate five quality posts in the discussion where you respond to other students. Post on different days. Don't do them all on one day. And then, give feedback, ask questions, or use your skills to generate conversation to help you and others learn the content. Now let's take a look at some of the time savers. These are things that students have reported are helpful in the past. Setting up notifications, same way about gradebook notifications. The Canvas calendar is kind of a cool tool. And the Canvas help feature, I know sometimes I just Google it and it comes up. And then screenshots, if you need to send me a screenshot, here's some assistance on how to do that. Now, I like to talk briefly about workload expectations, because I think, you know, I've been teaching online for a long time, and I think sometimes some people misperceive that online is going to be easy compared to sitting in a classroom. And that's really not the case. There's a lot of rigor in this course. And notice down here, this last bullet says, when calculating the hours per week this course could take, follow the math here. 3-credit course equals 45 contact hours. And you multiply that by 2 for study hours. So when you add those together, there's 135 hours of your time potentially that could be taken for during the semester to complete the course. And if you divide that 135 by the number of weeks in which you're taking the course, it gets you down to, as you can see, what does it say, 22 hours a week for 6 week. For a 16-week course, more like 9 hours a week. But still, that's time that you need to spend. In other words, you're going to need time to read the content, to practice the quizzes, to take the actual quiz, and then to prepare your discussion post, which in my thinking, preparing your discussion post might be one of the bigger ones time-wise. So you should have an expectation this is going to take some of your time, the same as sitting in a class. Because if you're sitting in a class, you'd be taking time each week to sit through the class, and then all of your work would be completed outside of the class. All right, some tools that students have found to be helpful. We've got the Writing Center, the Career Center, and the Technology Assistance Center. So these are links that are here to help you with that. Just let me run through policies real quick. All works delivered in electronic format. It's best, I think, to work on MS Word and then copy and paste it into the discussion post. Do not upload files. In other words, use Canvas. And use the Canvas inbox to communicate with me. It's helpful in the subject line to include your subject, and so I'll know. And on that, it's helpful to include the class. If you have life events that get in the way, you know, I will work with you. This may provide, may require some documentation, but let me know if you need help, and I'll work with you. Same way, if you have a disability and you're approved for accommodations, let me know. I'll work with you on that. The syllabus and course schedule are both subject to change. This is a collaboration. We're thinking that it should be pretty solid. But you know, you never know. So you want to check announcements on an ongoing basis. Okay, so now let's go back here and take a look. I wanted to take a look at modules for a minute here. Okay, once again, we've got. Let me get down to where the flow actually starts. Here, week 2 and 3, where we start the first really content module fundamentals. And you can see there'll be an overview video. You click on that, and then you're going to go in. You'll want to read your content. related to the chapter. You want to take your practice quizzes, complete your module quiz. Then you get into your situation. You either read a transcript or watch a video or both of the episode one. And then you're going to, and notice you have also part B. And then you have the competencies. You have A, B, and C. And notice there's content with each of these. So you want to use that content in overcoming the challenge or solving the challenge. And then you see you have a practice quiz associated with that. And then when you're done, you get down into episode two, which you are into the conclusion. So that's kind of the format you're going to work through. Once again, I'll have that conference number posted for office hours. If you want to check that out, I'll try to vary different times for that. So based on your schedules. So I'm glad you're here. I think you're going to find that the course content is very relevant and will be helpful to you and help you to prepare for your career goals. And and the text is built right in, which I think is an added convenience. And so I hope you find value in the course, and then I hope you enjoy the class as well. Thank you.